YouTube, hope everyone's doing well. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about these pair of leather saddle bags that I just made for my Honda VTX1800. Now, I think you guys might want to tune in. These have some very unique features that I don't think you typically see in a saddle bag. But let me talk about the philosophy a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and I get complaints that I'm not in the video, so here you go, everybody. Let me zoom in a little bit and I'll touch more on that philosophy. Okay, so if you can probably see from this video, these are just a simple pair of layover saddlebags. Think about a traditional saddlebag on a horse. Now, typically they're a solid piece of leather. This has two different straps, but it's the same concept. These aren't permanently affixed to the bike. I suppose you could take the seat off and put them underneath the seat for more of a permanent stance. However, when I designed these and built these, my reasoning and my purpose was I wanted something that I could take on and off the bike. What I discovered was that most of my riding, though this bike would be great for long freeway rides, most of my riding was really just short, leisurely jaunts around town, maybe just take it out and cruise it around a little bit, or take it to work. Now, I wanted a way to carry a minimal amount of luggage. And again, my intent here is not to pack for a weekend or take a tent or a sleeping bag. This is just to carry a few odds and ends if I'm out and about. Now, if you guys notice, I have this backrest here, which I really enjoy. Before I would just put on, you know, in most of the motorcycles I'd have, I'd just throw on a backpack and carry whatever I need in that. And then wherever I go, I walk off and the backpack's on my back. This backrest doesn't really make that a good option. Now, I suppose I could put the backpack there and strap it down in some way, but I want a little bit of more style. So, here we go. So, these are made of 8-ounce veg tan. These were completely handmade by myself. Let's talk about some of the features here. So, you can see it's got a two-tone. This is all vegetable tan leather, just a some of it's dyed differently than the others. They're held together with a clasp like this, and then inside you see some gear. But here is the real trick, and kind of coming back to that philosophy. So you can take them off like this. However, you can do this. Watch this. One of the bags comes off like this, and the layover straps are permanently affixed. But it also down here has these great big buckles and it's made to convert to a backpack. See these straps? It's got a carrying handle on the top. Let me see, I'll show you a little later. I don't know if this will show up. So you can throw it over your shoulder like this. Now, the other bag, because it's the reception end, if you will, of the layover portion, was a little bit different design, but I also wanted to make it in a way where it could be carried, easily carried. So what I did is I made a simple strap here. Again, there's a close-up of that buckle. The strap simply goes through here. Now, this converts to kind of like a messenger bag. So you can put it on, carry it like this. Now, the real advantage of this is not only does it make it easy for the bags to come on and off, but I think it gives a lot more versatility to the bags themselves. This would be a great messenger bag, and in fact, I am going to start carrying this every day just to carry around your normal stuff, right? So you may not want saddlebags on the motorcycle all the time, right? Or you don't want just bags that have to sit on the bike and have no other purpose. Now you have two different bag options, and these two bags are essentially identical in design and shape, with the exception that the carry mechanism is different. So one, a messenger bag, or two, a traditional backpack. Now, I won't lie to you. I think the messenger bag actually works really well, okay? The design, if I were to build this exclusively as a messenger bag, I'll admit, the design, I probably wouldn't attach the straps in this way, but of course we're adapting for something that has dual roles. But this actually is very comfortable and works very well. Now, for the backpack, this is kind of an odd backpack, but it works, and it's comfortable enough. And frankly, you know, you probably wouldn't go on a hike. You could, but you probably wouldn't go on a hike for something. You would probably just throw this over your shoulder and walk into work with it or something like that. And for those purposes, it works really well. Now, we're going to take another view here, and I want to kind of go over some of the features and construction a little bit more in depth. At the end of this video, I have, I think it's about 6 or 7 minutes of time-lapse videos showing the construction of these bags. So I'll get back to that in a moment. But like I said, these are 8-ounce veg tan, and for those that are not familiar, the 8-ounce reference is to the thickness of it. To be honest with you, I don't even remember exactly how it comes up with. I think it has to do with weight per a particular size. But the short order is this. The higher the ounce rating, the thicker the leather. So you could see right here that this is pretty thick leather. Vegetable tan, and if you're not familiar also with that, there's two primary tanning methods or how they process leather to where it will hold up. One is chrome tan. That's probably like the tanning method, for example, of how these seats are made. And then there's vegetable tan. Vegetable tan is kind of more of the traditional leather technique. And it allows you to do some unique things like stamping. So for example, on this strap here, if you guys can see, I did some hand tooling on this. I've got my little, see if it'll show up here in the video. I've got my classic Sasquatch stamp and I think they call it some sort of seashell. It's just meant to give it a little bit of a texture. I think it looks pretty attractive. So you can only do that with veg tan, though, and that's a stamping process. And in that time lapse, if you aren't careful, you might miss it, but you'll see a point where I'm actually doing that stamping. These are all hand sewn. This is 1 millimeter waxed thread. So you guys can see I used an orange color. I thought it was really attractive, particularly contrasting with the darker bag here. And then I used primarily, with some very minor exceptions, brass rivets. Those I think are very attractive and they make for a very, very strong attachment. The main components of the bag is this bag itself is really just one long piece of leather. So if you can kind of see here, you can just kind of imagine this singular piece of leather just wraps around, and then this part right here serves as a gusset, and this is all hand sewed. Okay, another thing you can do with veg tan is you can seal the edges. They call it burnishing the edges, and that's what gives it this uniform look. And then what I did is I cut out this piece, which is a separate piece of veg tan. I dyed it this color, and then I glued it, and then I hand sewed it in place. Same thing with this little piece. This handle was made. Essentially, it was a rectangular piece of veg tan that I wet. And that's another thing you do with veg tan is when you wet it, it allows you to form it into shapes. And then this is a stitch line to hold it together. And it's held on with rivets. Now the back here, is, and I did this to make sure this was really strong, this odd shape is a whole other piece of veg tan, hand-sewed and glued, and then this serves as the attachment point for the layover straps on the backpack version or the carry handle straps on this one. And the bag, I mean, I don't want to say it's simple because it did take a lot of work to make this, but it's overall a relatively simple design. And the backpack bag is essentially made in the same way, with the exception that it just has longer layover straps. And if you could see some of the tooling on there, I did a little Sasquatch figurine. And then these on the bottom with the great big brass buckle is just held on with brass rivets also. These will probably last a lifetime. They smell great. They have that leather, I don't know, you guys can pick it up in here, but that leather crinkling sound. They'll patina well. They'll form, they'll kind of essentially break in like a pair of boots to your body. I mean, even this strap, in just a short time I've been kind of using it, has formed into the shape of my shoulder. They're beautiful. I hope this light is doing it justice here, but I'm going to kind of give you guys a little turnaround view here. Now, I know my rivet attachments on the back here don't look pretty. Sometimes that happens, but that's not something that you're going to see all the time. But just stunning leather, stunning bags, I think. There's the inside. You can see the stitching shows through. I really like this latch mechanism. This is the first time I've used it. Makes it really easy to take, you know, open and close. You know, of course, it's not 100% sealed for security or water, but you know, it is what it is. So, all right, guys. So the next part of this is going to be that time lapse of the construction. Like I said, I'm only going to show the construction of one of the bags because they're essentially made the same. There might be bits and pieces that aren't in the time lapse, but I think you guys will get the general gist. I encourage you guys to continue watching, and I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks. All right, guys. Hey, I taped this last night, but I did want to add one more thing. I did take and put these bags on and ride around a little bit, and I kind of refined the design a little bit. But also, here's some images in natural light. Probably looks a little bit better. So what I did, though, was, so I loaded this bag up with a bunch of stuff, like if I were going to take this to work. And this other side here is completely empty. And I just kind of wanted to see how the weight shifted around. So it wasn't dangerous. This thing wasn't going to fall off. But I did notice that the bags obviously kind of shifted toward the heavy side. So what I did was I added a magnet, a really strong one. there we go. A magnet right there. So on my particular bike, when I put them on, I think you guys could probably hear that, the magnet sticks to this metal bar here that supports the backrest for the passenger. And that seemed to have really done the trick of keeping the bags from sliding side to side, and it just gives it a nice clean look. They're not going to flop around in the wind. But I'm very pleased with these. You could probably see that you could do a lot of adjustments on these. So for mine, I have them sitting kind of high, but you could always extend the holes and drop them lower. Of course, if you were going to use a magnet, you'd have to modify that magnet position. But I like the look of these. If I were to do them again, I actually might do the exact design, but just make them slightly bigger. But nonetheless, I think I'm very pleased with them. I think they turned out well. I think they look pretty good, and they're very, very functional. And you know, they're not for everybody, but for my purposes and my intent, they worked out really well. So stand by for the time lapse of the build process.